Deuteronomy chapter 6, verses 5 through 7. Love the Lord your God with all your heart, with all your soul, and with all your strength. These commandments that I give you today are to be on your hearts. Impress them on your children. Talk about them when you sit at home and when you walk along the road, when you lie down and when you get up. In Psalms 119:11, David said, "Your word have I hid in my heart, that I may not sin against you." And that's where we should keep the word of God today, right here. You know, today there's a lot of advertising on billboards, and TV, and the internet on things that ain't good. And young people, they turn to these things because that's what they see. Well, God wants his word taught to his people in just that same way. They should see it wherever they turn, because the human heart tends to forget God and his ways. You know, it's a strange thing when people are blessed, they tend to forget the one who blesses them.
That's exactly right. That's exactly right. And you know, as Jerry was reading that, I was thinking of something that I've said before. Knowledge is plentiful. Knowledge is plentiful with all these different avenues we have, with the computers and everything. Knowledge is plentiful. But we're not talking about knowledge. We're talking about true wisdom. True wisdom isn't intelligence or gathering up a bunch of facts. Contrary to popular belief, true wisdom is not found in education. True wisdom is to find and apply God's word to our lives. You see, when we walk in God's ways, we walk in wisdom. And like Jerry was talking about, as Christians, we need to share this true wisdom we have with this lost and dying world.
Ain't no doubt about it. You know, our faith, or our lack of faith, will be passed down to the generations that follow us. But what kind of legacy are we building for our children and grandchildren? You know, we're to teach them to know, to love, and to serve Jesus with all their heart. And we teach our kids by what we say, but we gotta do more than just tell the truth. We gotta live that truth out in our life.
Amen.
You know, we gotta love God with all our heart, with all our mind, and with all our strength before we can impress that on our kids. In other words, the kids should see that in us. Yeah, we gotta teach out our faith, but we also gotta live out our faith. And that's how we build a legacy for the generations to come.
Exactly right. You know, we were studying this, thought about a good example of passing that faith down, of living that faith out. Our parents are perfect examples of passing that faith down. You know, our mom and dad have always lived out their faith, serving God and sharing the good news of Jesus has always been priority in their lives.
You said a mouthful right there. We've seen it. We not only heard them say it, but we saw it. Just like you said, we saw it lived out. And I'm very grateful for that.
Amen. Amen. You know, I can't tell you how many times I've seen them step up in a time of need, whether it was just them giving of their time, whether they were giving of their finances, and always in prayer for whoever was having an issue. And the big thing about that, nobody ever knew it. On the flip side, certain things were expected of me and my brother. Going to church, being responsible, and being respectful, they were non-negotiable. Think about this. If parents today enforced these three simple rules, don't you think the world would be in much better shape?
Yeah.
So let us just go ahead and say it now. Mom, Dad, thank you for being Christian examples, not only with your words, but especially through your actions.
Couldn't have said that no better myself. That's the absolute truth, and this is the absolute truth.
And we'll see you on the next video.